स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
यस सर।
विजिबल ओके। So yesterday we were discussing instructions related to IO pins, how to set and reset IO pins, and then how to control the output devices, how you can send logic 0 and logic 1 with help of SBI and CBI instructions. So now let us study a few more instructions related to AVR microcontroller. One instruction utilized for comparison is CP. CP is the instruction which is very much useful for comparing the two registers. So like this, you can use a CP RD comma RS, where RD is a destination register, RS is a source register. You can compare two registers. And then based on comparison, there is a program control. That means you can take a branch. So for example, this is the instruction CP R1 and R0. So what it will do, it will compare the content of R1 and content of R0, and if both the contents are equal, then it will take a branch to the label next. So this is the next is the label, that is basically a memory location. So at that memory location, the branch will be taken. So BREQ is the instruction which will take a branch if both the content of register R1 and R0 are equal. So this is one comparison instructions which you can use in your program, right? Similarly, you can also compare registers with carry. So for example, here you can compare the registers R0, R1, R2 and R3 with four different instructions. So what is going on here is that you compare R0 and R4. If they are equal, you compare R1 and R5. If they are equal, it will compare R2 and R6 and then R3 and R7. That means if you are interested in comparing 32-bit numbers, because you know in AVR, every register is 8-bit register. So this R4 is 8-bit. This R5 is also 8-bit. R6 is also 8-bit. And R7 is also 8-bit. So that means total 32 bits are there. So this 32-bit number and this 32-bit number, both you can compare together. So if you want more than 8-bit, then you have to use the CPC. But if you want to only compare the 8-bit numbers, then only CP is required, because further you don't want to check. Only you want to check the 8 bits. Right? Because here, whenever R0 and R4 are equal, then only you are going for R1 and R5. If R0 and R4 itself is not equal, there is no meaning of checking other bytes, right? So that's actually main purpose here. Then at last, there is a BREQ next. That means if all four registers are equal, the jump will be taken at the label next. Otherwise, jump will not be taken. Then it's also possible to compare register with immediate number. So in this case, you can see that CPI RD comma K. So RD is a register. So RD can be any register from R16 to R31, and K is any immediate number. So to understand this instruction, let us take example CPI R20 comma 100. So in this case, R20 will be compared with 100. If it is equal to 100, then zero flag will set. So here there are two possibilities. You can take a branch with help of BREQ or BRNE. If you write here BRNE, then branch if R20 is not equal to 100. So in that case, if it is not equal to 100, then branch will be taken. And if you want to take a branch, whenever if it is equal to 100, then you can write BREQ. So there are two instructions, BREQ as well as BRNE. You can use any one out of it. So ultimately, it will compare the value of register with immediate number specified after it. If both the numbers are equal, zero flag will set. And if zero flag will be set, so now you have to decide whether you want to take a branch, whether whenever both are not equal or equal. If you want to take a branch, if both are not equal, then you use BRNE. If you want to take a branch, if both are equal, then you use BREQ. So choice is yours in your program. Then there is the instruction CPAC. CPAC means compare two registers and skip next instruction if both the registers are equal. So for example, CPAC R4 and R0. So it will compare both the registers. And if both the registers are equal, then this instruction will not be executed. Right? So this will not be executed if R4 is equal to R0. Otherwise, this instruction will be executed. Right, so this negative of this number, R4, value of R4 will be calculated if both the numbers are not equal. If both are equal, this negative will not be calculated. So that's how this instruction will work. Am I audible? My voice is coming properly.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it's coming. All right. So now let us understand this compare instruction with help of one example. I will try to explain you this example in which we will read the value from port C, compare that value with a reference value 0x64. If you take the decimal value of it, it will be 100. And if the reading of port C is equal to 0x64, we would like to set the bit PB0. Right? So that is the purpose actually. So this is the program for it. Now all of you are very much familiar with this instruction. SBI DDRB, 0, that means we set PB0 as an output. Why we set it as an output? Because we want to set the bit. Whenever our port C value is equal to 0x64, then only we want to change the, we want to set this particular pin, PB0. So for that purpose, actually, we are defining PB0 pin as an output. Then we want to read the port C. So for example, port C, we have to set the direction of that port C as an input direction. And to set as an input, we have to transfer 00 to R16 and then R16 to DDRC. DDRC register is a data direction register for port C, and it is responsible to set the direction of port. Can anyone tell me, if I want to use this port C as an output, what I should do, what modification I should do in these instructions? Any one of you can unmute your microphone and tell me. પોર્ટ સીને આપણે ઇનપુટ તરીકે ના વાપરવો હોય પણ આઉટપુટ તરીકે વાપરવો હોય તો આ બે ઇન્સ્ટ્રક્શનની અંદર કઈ જગ્યાએ આપણે ચેન્જ કરવો પડે? યુ કેન જસ્ટ રિમેમ્બર અવર યેસ્ટરડેઝ ટોક in which we were using ports as an output port. We connected LEDs, so we use port as an output port. So if you just remember yesterday's talk, I think you will be able to answer. I will not go ahead if you do not answer, right? So any one of you should unmute your microphone and answer the question. And if you do not know, please say that, sir, we don't know, so that I can explain it again. Let me see, now I have to tell by name. Josie Urvi is present. Josie Urvi, Harshit Gedia, Nakum Gautam, Jigar Damelia, Kaushal Bodhar, any one of you can unmute your microphone and tell me the answer. My question is clear to you or not? Is it not possible for you to unmute your microphone and speak? Jigar Damelia, can you start your video? Josie Urvi, can you start your video and answer my question? And mute your microphone, start your video, and then answer the question. Lokesh Joshi. Why don't you want to interact, because due to interaction you will learn a lot, if you just listen. And now onwards, whatever the name I speak, if you do not answer, I will make you absent, because it means that you are not present there. You have just started the meeting and then you are away from your laptop or mobile. So, one by one I will speak and then you have to say yes and then you have to answer. Otherwise, I will mark you as an absent, right? So, first of all, Josie Urvi is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so whatever I am speaking, you listen or not? Why don't you reply?
That I was not aware of the answer.
Then you should tell me that, I am not aware of answer and, no one is speaking. So sometimes I feel that, you have started the meeting and then you are away from the meeting. Okay. Jigar Damelia. Jigar Damelia.
Yes, sir.
You know answer?
No, sir.
Okay, you don't know. Anyone who knows the answer?
Sir, Didier
Steve. Okay, now let me show that slide again. So your point is here that instead of Didier, my question was this, that if I want to use these, this port is useful here as an input port, but I want to utilize as an output port, then what should I do? That was actually the question. You got it? What I have done here to utilize this as an input, I have done it that LDI R16 comma 0x00 means 00 is transferred to R16 and R16 is transferred to DDRC. I want to utilize this as an output port. As all of you are not knowing, I will write it here. If you want to utilize as an output, what I should do here is LDI R16 comma 0xff and then out DDRC comma R16. So if I declare like this, then my port is an output, and if I declare in this way, if I specify 00, then my port is input. That means in a DDRC register, if bit is 1, then it is that particular pin is output. If bit is 0, that means that particular pin is input. Yesterday we have also seen one example in which individual pin you can set as input and output. So individual you can do with help of SBI and CBI, but entire port you can do with help of LDI and out instruction. Now I think this must be clear to all of you. Is there any doubt? Let us make a lecture interactive. So you in between you give the answers, so that you know I can feel like in a classroom. It's you know, otherwise it is very difficult to teach just sitting you know in front of laptop. You know, I always like live lectures, but you know, this is actually what we have to, you know, this is an alternative arrangement. So in that I should feel that I am giving lectures to the classroom, right? LDI R16 comma.
Sure.
Yes, please. Please ask.
તમે જે રીતના instruction આપ્યા તેમાંથી ઓલું LDI R16 0x00 અને 0xFFE એઝ અ સ્વિચ વર્ક કરે ને, કે જ્યારે 00 હોય બે બીટ ત્યારે ઇનપુટ તરીકે લઈએ.
તમારી આઉટપુટ તરીકે કામ કરે. મારે ધારો કે ચાર જ પિન ને આઉટપુટ કરવી છે, તો આ ચાર જ હું 1 રાખીશ, બાકીના બધાને 0 રાખીશ, બાકી બધું 0, એટલે 0F થઈ જશે. બરાબર. એટલે મારે જે પિનને આઉટપુટ તરીકે વાપરવી હોય એ પિનને કરસ્પોન્ડિંગ બીટને મારે 1 કરવાનો છે, અને જે પિનને મારે ઇનપુટ તરીકે વાપરવી હોય એનો કરસ્પોન્ડિંગ બીટ છે એ મારે 0 રાખવાનો છે. ઓકે ઓકે. નાવ લેટ મી ગીવ યુ વન એક્સરસાઇઝ સો દેટ યુ નો ઇટ બીકમ્સ વેરી ક્લિયર ટુ ઓલ ઓફ યુ. લેટ મી સ્વિચ ટુ ધીસ વ્હાઇટ બોર્ડ. ઓકે. નાવ કન્સિડર દેટ યુ નો I am giving instruction in this way. Let me select the pen. I give the instruction in this way. LDI R16 0x55. And then if I give instruction in this way, out DDRC comma R16, what will happen? What will be the status of PC0, PC7 and all that? Let me write all these bits here. PC7, PC6, PC5, PC4, PC3, PC2, PC1 and PC0. What will be the status? 55 means this will be 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. So what will be PC7, whether it will be output or input?
Input.
packet will be input because it is we have written 0 there, and PC6 will be output. PC5 will be again input. PC4 will be output. Right. So in essentially, we can say that PC0, PC2, PC4, PC6, all even pins will be output pins, and odd pins will be input pins. Right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
And let's write, let me say that I am writing in this way, LDI R16 0x F0, and then I write out DDRD comma R16. Okay, now tell me what pins will be output pins and what pins will be input pins. This F0 means it, you can write in this way. Okay.
This is 765.
Okay.
It's input.
PD7 to PD5. 5 or 4? 7654. PD4. These are input or output?
Output.
It will be output, right? Fine. And D, because we have written here DDRD, so it is related to port D. PD3 to PD0 will be input in this way, right? So if I am writing here FF, then all pins will be output. If I am writing 00, all pins will be input. And depending on this bit combinations, you have input and output pins. So I think now it is very much clear to you, right? Whenever there is a doubt, you please ask. Otherwise, I will understand that you have understood all, and then I will go ahead, right? So whenever if you have any doubt, you can ask in between, so that your doubts can be clarified immediately, right? Okay. So now look, let's move ahead. This is an instruction in which we are transferring the reference value 64 to R16. So, because we want to compare our input port with a 64 values, that's why this reference value is transferred to R16. Then we are reading a port. So, this is a new instruction for you in R17, pin C. So, here we are using intentionally, instead of port D, we are using pin C because we want to read something from the port. So while reading, you have to specify pin C. And there is an instruction called CP. CP R16, R17. So what it will do, it will compare the value of R16 and R17, and if both are equal, then a branch will be taken. So BREQ instruction is for that purpose. Branch will be taken to the label next. And what we want to do, we want to compare, and if its reading is equal to 0x64, we want to set bit PB0. So BREQ says that both are equal, then it will jump to next, and in this next label we have written the instruction SBI port B comma 0. So this instruction is useful to set the PB0 pin. And if both are not equal, what will happen? It will clear that bit. So it will execute CBI port B comma 0. So it will clear PB0 pin, and then again it will jump to check the port C. So this is how this instruction will work. Now, what is actually application of this program? If you look at the practical applications, where it will be useful, can you think of any practical applications where this program will be useful? Where you need to read something and you want to, execute something whenever both input is equal to certain reference value.
Find a greater number, maybe something like that.
AC, suppose if you have a AC and you have set the temperature let's say 22 degree centigrade. So whenever you know it will reach up to the your room temperature will reach up to the 222 degree centigrade, automatically compressor will become off, right? So basically what it is does doing, it is continuously comparing with a 22. Whenever you set temperature as a 22, it will continuously compare with the 22, and whenever it will reach to the 22, automatically compressor will become off. So that is one application, temperature controller you can use for this application. Then there is a liquid level controller also. Liquid level controller in which you know sensors are placed at different level. You read the sensor values, and whenever you know entire tank is filled with the liquid, you can switch off the motor. And whenever the tank is empty, you can switch on the whenever the tank is full, you can switch off the motor, and whenever the tank is empty, you can switch on the motor. So like this you can take the readings, and based on the readings you can do some action. You remember any other examples, any other practical examples that you can use for the this program? There are so many real life applications in which we are using this situation. Just remember anyone and then you can tell me. Whenever you set the alarm, the same thing is happening, right? In alarm, you set the, you know, hours, minutes and seconds. So you set one reference. Basically, when you set the alarm, you are setting basically reference time. And when you know your time is equal to reference time, the alarm will energize. So that is also one example of this this type of a program. Right. Any other you can remember and tell me, just share me. Or you think at home and then during the next lecture you can also share. Right. Okay. Let's go ahead. Another version of the same program with different instructions, like CPSC instruction. CPSC instruction in which we say that whenever both the comparison is resulted, you can compare and skip the next instruction. So in that case, again, this is very much similar to the previous program, SBIDDRB, 0, it will make this port PB0 output. Again, I will ask the question, suppose now I don't want to set this PB0 as an output, but I want to set this PB0 as an input, what instruction I should use instead of SBI? Can you tell me? Any one of you can unmute your microphone and answer the question. Which book you are using for this microcontroller subject, microprocessor and microcontroller subject? And are you reading something at home or not? Or just you are attending lecture and then forget everything? Because this is the point just we discussed yesterday. And I have recorded entire lecture on YouTube. You can also refer always later on. If you were not present in previous lecture, you can just refer it by that YouTube lecture. And this today's lecture is also being recorded on YouTube, and it will be also available to you in the same channel. I am recording every lecture so that you know if you are busy during the lecture, you will be able to refer it later. Or even if you are attending and if you want to understand it again, you can refer that lecture later on. So all the my lectures are recorded and available on the YouTube. So can anyone tell me what and even if you do not know, just unmute your microphone and tell me, yes, sir, we don't know. My question is that here to set this PB0 as an output, we use SBI. To set this PB0 as an input, what instruction we should use?
Sir, CBI.
CBI, very good. So if you use CBI port B, so not port B but DDRB, comma 0, then our PB0 will be input pin. But we want to declare PB0 output because on a PB0 pin, we have an output device. So whenever there is output device connected on pin, you have to set that pin as an input. Whenever there is a input device is connected, you have to set that pin as an input pin. So at present, we have an output device. So PB0 we are initializing as an output pin. Then these two instructions, again same as previous program, 00 we are transferring to R16. R16 we transfer to DDRC. So port C will be output port with help of these two instructions. CBI port B, 0. So initially we clear the PB0 pin. So PB0 output will be 0 initially. So if some device is connected with PB0 pin, it will remain off. Suppose if you are controlling solenoid with help of a PB0 pin, then that solenoid will remain off. Then reference value we will load to the R16 register. Then we read the port C. So we transfer pin C value to R17 register. And this is the instruction. Because of this entire program we have written. CPAC, compare and skip next instruction if both are equal. If both are not equal, then next instruction will be executed. That means R jump continues will be executed. So this R jump, what it will do? It will jump to this particular same label, CONT label. So the same instruction will be repeated again and again until your port C reading is equal to reference value, right? So continuously it will read the port, transfer it to R17. We compare R17 and R16 continuously. If both are equal, then only we will escape from out of this loop. Otherwise, the same loop will be executed continuously. What will happen if both the registers are equal? R16 and R17 will be equal. At that time, we will come out from the loop because we are basically skipping this next instruction. And because of that, we are coming out of this loop. And after coming out from this loop, we execute this instruction SBI port B, 0. So this instruction will make your PB0 pin equal to 1. So for example, if you are controlling solenoid with help of a port B0 pin, then this solenoid will turn on with help of this instruction. Right. And suppose if you want to do reverse, you want to switch off something whenever the things are equal, then you have to do reverse. Right. What is the modification you require? Initially, you make high with help of SBI, and then whenever both are equal, you write here CBI. So that is depending on the requirement, whether you want to switch on the device or switch off the devices. It also depends how your device is connected with the port pin. Okay, any doubt in this program? If you have any doubt, you can ask so that I can clarify your doubt. If you know, if you do not have any doubt, if you have understood it, let's go ahead. Okay. After execution of this instruction, what will be the status of carry flag, half carry flag, and zero flag? This is exercise for you. So just solve it and then give me the answer. Now 7F means 0. 1 1 1, F means 1 1 1 1. So this will be content of R16. R17 would be 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 1, and we are performing addition of this. So 1 plus 1 is a 1 0, so 0 will come, 1 carry, 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 0 will come, 1 carry. So 1 plus 1 again 0 will come, 1 carry, 1 plus 1 again 0 will come, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, again 0 will come in 1 carry. So this will be result. So now tell me what will be the status of carry flag, half carry flag and zero flag. I have made your job very easy now because I have already computed the addition. Should I call you one by one or any volunteer who will give me an answer? I think I have to call you by name only. Number 11124, Leonie, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What is your answer?
Sure, I don't.
You don't know. Okay. Kausal. Kausal is there. What is your answer, Kausal? Meera Patel is there.
Yes, sir.
You want to give any answer?
No, sir. No idea.
This is actually not that much, difficult. While giving that, I already given that answer. That all flag will set. Because, this 7F means 0, let me start my pen here. Let me start this. 7F means 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, all over this one, and then 8, 1 means, have you not studied the digital electronics? In digital electronics, this type of sum is coming actually. 1 is carry. All these are 0, 0, 0. So now a result is a 0, so 0 flag will set, Z equal to 1. Carry flag is available here because this is a carry, so carry flag will also set. Half carry means the carry generated out of nibbles. Every addition generates the carry here. So everywhere carry is there. So from this, the one nibble is carry is generated. So this is actually because of this, your half carry is also, or your half flag will also there. So half carry is also 1. So H flag is also 1. So answer is this, C, H and Z, all flag will set. Now tell me this answer. What will be the status of the flag, sign flag, N flag and Z flag? If you are having a R16 0x02 and then this content you are decrementing 2 times and then you are complementing. 0x02 means if you decrement it, it becomes 01, then again if you decrement it, it becomes 00, and again you make complement of it, it becomes FF. So S and N will set because sign flag, your sign will change. This FF means it is equivalent to minus 1 and it is also negative number, so N will also set. 0 will not set because answer is not 0. So 0 will not set. So do some practice about it and you will be able to learn it. And if you have any doubt further, you can ask during the next lecture to me or to Niranjan sir to clarify your doubts. Now let us take few rotate instructions. LSL that is a logical shift left, that is the instruction. So ultimately this instruction will shift your content of register to the left side. So for example, if you have a R0 in this way, let me call this R0 is let's say 0x01, in a binary it is a 000001. This is binary value of this 0x01. And if you give this instruction LSL R0, all the bits will shift left by one bit position. Okay, so ultimately after this instruction, your content of R0 would be 000010. So this one is shifted left once, and this position list's LSB position will be filled with 0. So this will be your shifted position. So it is 0x02. Further, if you give one more shift, let's say after this also you give LSL R0, what will happen? Again it will shift. So it becomes 000100. So it becomes 0x04. Further, if I will do like this LSL R0, what will happen? Again it will shift to the left side. 000100. So again it becomes 0x08. So every time, you know, whenever you shift left one bit position, every time your number will be multiplied by 2. You can see here, initially number was 1. After shifting at once, it will becomes 2. Again, if you shift, it becomes 4. Again, if you shift, it becomes 8. And so on, you know, every time it will, your number will become double whenever you shift left. Similarly, if you shift right, then what will happen? Your number will be divided by 2, because in that case you will be shifting to the right direction. So that's why in that case your number will be divided by 2. If you shift to the left side, your number will be multiplied by 2. Is it clear? Any doubt? Okay, so just whatever we have discussed, you refer it. Our next lecture will be purely instruction lecture. In that lecture, I will just ask the questions. I will not explain anything. I will ask the questions. You have to just reply me. You have to reply my questions. And I will call you one by one. And I will ask you, and you have to reply the questions. So next lecture will be purely interactive lectures, you know. So it will not be a one way, it will be a two way instruction. Okay, if you have any doubt you can ask, otherwise I will stop my lecture here.